Good morning. For those of you expecting to hear about the next high-tech innovation, I'll have to disappoint you. I'm no Elon Musk. I'm here to call bullshit. I'm here to call bullshit on a deeply rooted belief system, a dogma, a habit, an addiction, call it what you like, that is driving us to ecological and societal collapse like a bunch of zombies. And that, my friends, is the idea of infinite economic growth. According to the IPCC, globally, economic growth is the main driver of climate change. Or, otherwise put, the main cause of greenhouse gas emissions is the excessive consumption of material goods. You see, during the past century, our economy has grown massively. And this has brought us unprecedented wealth. And we thought, the sky is the limit. Now, unfortunately, something else happened in the sky as well. CO2 accumulated and its concentration increased at almost the same rate as the global economy. And in fact, if we look at the last 20 years, any increase in global economic output went hand in hand with increased CO2 emissions. This should have all alarm bells going off. But this also points us towards a solution. Because apparently, we already figured out how to reduce emissions in 2009. Great. What happened then? A global financial crisis caused a drop in consumption and our emissions finally decreased. So it's clear, right? The fastest and most effective way to reduce emissions is to shrink. And that's just fine, because economic growth is expected to decrease anyway, exactly because of climate change effects. But don't panic. Because today, economic wealth and social well-being no longer correlate in Western societies. There is a limit to the happiness money can buy. And what money can't buy are our social interactions, our health, and our freedom. See, I'm just a messenger here. And I need all of you to join me and question this illusion of infinite economic growth. Because today, the solution to the climate crisis is to be humble again and shrink. Thank you for listening.